Okay, now in this video, we'll explain Lecture 9 in electronics course. Lecture 9 talks about source transformation. But first of all, we would like to revise the sources that we talk, the type of sources that we talk. There are two basic types of sources, voltage source and the current source, where source can be independent or independent. So we have two types of sources, voltage source or current source. Voltage source or current source. Some of voltage sources can be independent and some of voltage sources can be dependent. Some of current sources can be independent and some of current sources can be dependent. Independent source denoted by a circle. So it is a independent circle, independent voltage source, and this is an independent current source since they are circles. Dependent source denoted by diamond, so it is a dependent voltage source, and this is a dependent current source. How can I discriminate between the voltage source and the current source? The current source is discriminated by an arrow. Voltage source is shown by positive and negative voltages. The idea of source transformation is to make a simplification of the given circuit. Source transformation is a method for simplifying the electrical circuit. But a source transformation simplify doesn't simplify the whole circuit, but it simplify a portion of the circuit. Okay. Which portion of the circuit exactly? The circuit that contain a voltage source with a series resistor. Okay. So source transformation can simplify this component by replacing this part by a current source with a parallel resistor. Okay. Then we complete the circuit. We have this resistor, we have the current source, we have resistor here. This will be the transformation that will be applied using the source transformation. It replaces a small part of the circuit with another equivalent part. Okay. This operation can be vice versa, such that if this was the input circuit and I have current source with a resistor in parallel, I can replace this part with a voltage source with a series resistor. Okay, so I have two types of source transformation: current to voltage source transformation and voltage to current source transformation. Current to voltage, the input was current and the output was volt. Okay. The input and the output. The output circuit. Or I can, this type of source transformation and this type, I have two types. The second type is called voltage to current, and such that the voltage is the input circuit, is in the input circuit, and I would like to transfer it to a current source in the output circuit. Okay. In other words, if I have this part of the circuit, and I would like to replace it to be applying the source transformation, I will have the current source with parallel resistor. Okay. If I have this circuit as the input, I can replace it with the voltage source with series resistor. Okay. This operation can be swapped. This is the main idea of source transformation. Okay, for a simple example of a source transformation, if I have this part of the circuit and I would like to replace it with this part of the circuit, I have the value of the resistor in the input circuit But I in the output circuit or in the equivalent circuit, I don't have a value of resistor here, so it is assumed to be unknown until now, and the current source is not known until now. For the input circuit, I have I know the resistor value and the voltage value. If I replace this part of circuit to this part, what will be the value of the the resistor? It will be five. It will be the same value of the old circuit. If it is five, so it will be the same value, which is 5 ohm. For the current value, it will be get using Ohm's law, which states that I equal V over R. Will V for this example is 20 over R, which is 5. So result will be 4. So the current value will be 4 ampere. Okay. Again, if I would like to get the values of the resistor and the current source after doing the source transformation, the output resistor will be the same value of the input resistor. The current will be the same current will be given by using the Ohm's law, which says that I equal V over R. V the input V and the R is the input R. Okay. Again, there is two more information about the source transformation. The first information is that the direction of current, if the input voltage source is if the positive terminal is on top, so the arrow will be directed to the top also. So the arrow of the current source is directed towards the positive terminal of the voltage source. If the positive is top, so the arrow is top. And again, if the voltage is in this shape, I will reverse, I will do source transformation. After doing source transformation, I will get the current to be in this direction. Okay? This is for the direction of the current after applying source transformation. Second information is that the source transformation is not possible. Is not possible if R is equal to 0 for voltage source. Again, if I would like to transform this part of circuit to be to get the current source, and R here is equal to 0, the source transformation is not possible. We cannot do source transformation. Why? Since the resistor here is 0, so the resistor here will be 0. Okay? But the current value will be V over R, which is V over 0. V over 0. Which is not correct. If this operation, if I have this input circuit and I would like to go in the apply source transformation, and resistor equal to infinity, again this is not this cannot be is not possible, since the voltage value here will be V equal I multiplied by R, I multiplied by R, which is I multiplied by infinity. Okay? So if I have this input circuit and the R equals 0, the transformation is not possible, since the current value will be V over R. Okay? If I would like to get to apply source transformation using this input circuit and the resistor is equal to infinity, the transformation is not possible, since V will be I multiplied by infinity. Okay. This is an example that we will use to we'll solve using source transformation. It asks to find the power associated with the six source using the source transformation method. Okay. In any example, when it asks to get to find any variable, you have the right to use any other method you prefer. But if it asks to get this value using the source transformation or a specific method, you have to use this specific method. Okay. So for this example, it asks to get using the source transformation. Power at 6 volt. Power at 6 volt equal I multiplied by V. I value I don't know I value, but I have voltage value. Current value is the same current that passed through a resistor 4, since these sources are series together. So we would like to apply source transformation to get the current value. Source transformation to get the current at I4. To get this 4 ampere, 4 ohm. Okay? So how to apply source transformation in this method? First, I have to look at the circuit and see which part can be converted to be to apply source transformation on. As can be shown, this part, this voltage source has a series resistor, and this voltage source has a series resistor. I can apply source transformation in this source, but I cannot apply this source transformation in this part. Since in the question it asked about the power at 6 volt, so I cannot replace this part. It must be remain fixed during the answer, since it is a main component at which I will get the power. So I will do source transmission in this part only. Okay, time. After applying the source transformation in this part, I will get this circuit will be replaced to be this circuit, such that the 5 will be the same 5. The current source will be the V over R. The V is 40 and the R is 5, so it will be 40 over 5, which is 8. So the current source value will be 8. So this is the first step of answering this question. We can refer to the rule of the power. We can refer to a rule of the power as step one. Okay. For this example, source transformation is the second step. So second step is to apply source transformation for voltage source and series resistor to be current source with a parallel resistor. Okay. This is for the first step. The second step, the third step is to get the equivalent resistor of these two components, since they are parallel. So R will be, R equivalent will be 20 parallel with L5. So the circuit will be 4, 6, 30, 10, and and 4 with the current source. This is the result circuit, resulting circuit of of the third step, 6, 4, 6, 4, the equivalent of 20 and 4 parallel with 4 is 20 parallel with 5 is 4 ohm. So this resistor is 10. This resistor is 30. This is for the third step. Okay, the four is here. The resulting circuit after applying the third step is the 4 is parallel with the current source. Okay. This is the third step. As we can see, we did a source transformation for voltage source, and we did a second source transformation. So we in the source transformation method, you can apply series of source transformation. Okay. For the fourth step, I will convert this circuit. I will convert this circuit to this circuit in step four. Step four, apply a source transformation in the cell 3 times. Okay? Source transformation. So apply source transformation to this part, lower 4 with 8, to be the 4 with 32 voltage source. Okay, this will be the fourth step. After having this circuit, we can, I don't remember if it is the fifth or but I think it is fifth step. I will do source transformation to this part to be this part. Sorry, to Z. I will get the equivalent of this component, which is in fifth step, the equivalent will be 20. So I have 4 with 30 and 20 voltage source. D30. D4, D20, D32. Okay. For the sixth step, we apply again source transformation. Okay, C D. Source transformation to convert this part to be this part. Okay. الريزيستور is 20, so the resistor will be 20. The voltage source is 32, current source will be 30 over 20, which is 1.6. Okay, this for the sixth step. The last step is to get the equivalent resistor of these two step, which will be LR 20 is parallel with LR 30. The equivalent value will be 12, which will be series with L4. Okay. The resulting seventh step is to get the equivalent of these two bar. This is the resulting circuit. Okay. The eighth step is to make another source transformation for this circuit. Then we will get the eighth step to get the KVL on this loop. After applying KVL on this loop, I will have 4i plus 12i plus 90.2 minus 6 equals 0. I will solve to get i. Then I will substitute by the I value in the power to get the value of the power. Okay? If it asks to get the source transformation, you may use a series of source transformation. Okay? This is all for this lecture.